Hey everyone, this is the next video in the series about annotations in Java. So far we have covered all these four topics, questions, what, why, how, built-in and meta annotations, right? So in this video, I'm going to explain you how we can create our own custom annotations, right? Like there are built-in annotation that we use. So what if there is need to use our own annotations as per our own requirement? So let's go ahead and see how we can start creating the annotations. So this is the annotation Java demo program that we have seen so far. So let me go ahead and create our, so before we start creating, let's see any existing annotation that is there and what is specific about that. Suppose I'm going to this override. So this override annotation is there, this interface keyword is there, and this @ annotation is there, right? So this way we create annotations, right? So let me go ahead and create new Java class and name it my annotations, right? So this is in IntelliJ IDE, I can see class interface in the main annotation. If I select annotation, it is going to put @ directly, right? So let me select with interface, right? So it is the interface, and the moment I select @, so it is now annotations, right? So let's see what next. Next we have target and we have retention. So what is this about target? So you use annotations. So if I show you this program, you use annotations at the level of method, right? So you are using above method, right? And this separation warning annotation you are using at the class level, right? And there are annotations which are used at parameter level, at field level, right? So this target annotation is there to help you, right? So if I here this, it is method label, so the type that is mentioned, only that places you can use, right? So this override annotation is allowed to be used only at method level, so you cannot use this annotation at class level or at field level, right? What other options are available? See, if I come here, so element type, we have type, field, parameter, constructor, and all these things, right? So as per our requirement, we can choose whatever we need. And retention, so when you are writing the program, so there are different phases, right? So you have a source code phase, you have compilation phase, you have runtime phase, right? So at which place you want this, right? So this override phase is there, this override annotation is applicable at the source level. So when you convert, whenever you are using this annotation in Java demo and you are using this override annotations, right? So you are not going to see, when you are going to see the class of this annotations, right? So if you go and see the class, so you won't be able to see this @ override annotation, right? So it is there for source code label only. So let's see what other labels are there. So their class label, their runtime label, right? So runtime means you will see that at class file is generated, so at that label it is there, right? So you can read out the informations respective also, right? So let me go ahead and use this in our annotations also. So first, where I need this, right? So element type, I want it at method label, and I can also pass multiple values, right? So I can have it method label, right? So not method. Next, I want it at field label also. So if there is any field, I want this annotation to be used, right? Now next, this has not any value, right? So this has this annotation doesn't have any member, right? So if I come here and show you here suppress warning, it has one member, right? So if you go here and see this, it has this field, this member value, right? So this I want in our annotation, so I can go ahead and have on our own custom fields, right? So suppose I want this annotation to have some message, right? So this is it that we need. So our annotation is ready with this my annotation, and I have to pass this message and then it will be recognized, right? So next field, what I want, suppose this is next I want cost, variable, anything that you want, right? So int cost, so it should be some method, right? So this is how. So whenever you are using this annotation at any class label, you have to specify the value of the message, value of the cost also, right? Right. So next, target we have, and retention also we have to mention. So I have to mention the retention policy. Retention policy, I want it at runtime, right? So apart from this, I can have annotation documented. So whenever you are using this my annotation and you are creating the document out of that, it will be documented when you are using this annotations, right? So this is it. Our annotation is ready. We are ready to use this, right? So let's go ahead and create a class and use this annotation. Going ahead, I want here some field. So these are the two field, type and item, that we have in this one, right? So I can go ahead and create the getter and setter for this, just to have some methods. All right, so I can also have alt insert constructor with both the types, right? Our class is ready. We have some field, we have constructor, we have methods also, right? So my annotation, it is applicable at method and field level. So let's go ahead and use this. So field level, I can have my annotations, right? So it is saying that you should specify some value, right? So you should give message. This is type field, right? And also you have second field, that is cost, and what cost it has, you have to specify that also. 1, 2, 3, right? So the type also you should take care. If you are not specifying the specific type, it is going to throw an error. Static typing is strong right here, like in all the cases in Java, right? So this is how you can use it. And in some of the cases, you do not want to specify this message, you want to have some default message for each field, we can do also that, right? So what you can specify the default message for any field, default value, default message, whatever you want, right? So if I'll not be forced to use this message attribute whenever I'm using, right? So if I use this annotation at method level, my annotation, so I'll be able to so if you see the if I give the cost here only 2, 3, I'm good to go, right? So the message, what will be there when we will be reading this annotation, we will see this default message, right? So this is how you can create the annotation and you can use the annotation in your class, right? So this annotation is applicable at method and field level, and anywhere if you try to use this, if I use this at my annotation, it is not applicable here, right? So my annotation not applicable to type, right? So if I have to remove this, and if I go ahead and try to use this at constructor level also, it is not applicable, right, to constructor. And if I go ahead and mention one more type here, element type constructor, so the error will be gone, right? So now it is applicable. So cost, if I give it, it is going to work properly, right? So this is how you can use the, and these the annotations that you use to create custom annotations are known as meta annotations, right? Target, retention, documented, and there is one more annotation, that is inherited, right? So these are known as meta annotations. As in the last video, I have explained you the difference between built-in annotations and meta annotations, right? So as per your requirement, you can have as many fields that you want to have, right? So this is how you can create the custom annotations. In the next video, I'm going to explain you how you can read out these annotations, right? So when your application is starting and you have used custom annotations, how will read those annotations and how you act as per those annotations, right? So whatever value is given here, right? So we use Reflection API to read out the annotations, right? So I'll explain this to you in the next video, right? So all the source code and this video and other video links are given in the description box. Go ahead and check out those, right? So I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Bye bye.